Effective video doesn't need to all be epic drone shots and aesthetic b-roll. Even just words on screen can be incredibly powerful, and with a little style and a little imagination, they can be used to not just tell your story, but to convey the feeling that you're trying to communicate. And that's what we're going to be experimenting with today, just in Canva. KINETIC TEXT, very much like you just saw in that intro sting actually, is an animation technique that uses color, scale, and movement of text on screen to communicate in a very fun, powerful, and effective way. But it has traditionally been really time-consuming to create, even in the best of professional software. These days, however, Canva's new animations and transitions within their video editing tool has made it much easier to recreate this kind of effect. So today, I'm going to walk you through, frame by frame, how I used Canva's tools to create this KINETIC TEXT video. Sometimes these kind of animated videos, particularly with text, start with the music because somebody hears a piece of music or has a piece of music and they're inspired by that, and that can help dictate the movement. But with this one that I'm going to show you today, I started with the words on screen, how I wanted them to move and animate, and then I came back to fine-tune and put the music in towards the end of the process. So let's have a look where we started. We're working with a standard YouTube video sized design today because it gives me a bit more screen space so that I can show you how this works and try some of these effects. And the first thing I started with was just a plain blank page, and I decided to choose a bold serif font to use for my text throughout. With these kinds of KINETIC TEXT videos, it's best to stick to one or two bold fonts. You can introduce others that act as a highlight, but in general, it's best to not overcomplicate it because there's going to be a lot of movement and a lot of scaling of different fonts and pieces of text. So sticking to one bold font or one consistent font throughout the video is usually a good way of doing it. Now, I'm a big fan of black and white text in these videos, but I wanted to introduce some color into this one, and I used this pop of pink immediately on the full stop so that from the beginning implies that there's going to be a couple of these little surprises of color. And that's because the message behind this and the feeling I want to convey is about creativity. At the bottom here, you'll see between all of these thumbnails, on most of them, I've used the match and move transition between them. And this is one of Canva's newest transitions, and it essentially fills in the gaps of animation frames, if you will, between one state of something and another. So for example, the word hello here, I have the text box in the middle of the screen, and on the next slide, I have the text box a little bit to the left. And you'll see if I drag the playhead, Canva actually fills in the gaps between those with a little animation because I've used that match and move. Now the other text box, this let's begin, I've also brought on using the match and move technique, and that's because if you have a look at the previous slide, you'll see it's actually here. It's just off the side of the slide, so we can't see it. So all Canva's doing is moving it from there to the center of the screen. So that's how match and move essentially works, and that's what I've used for a lot of these animations. Now the next slide, I wanted to have a stark contrast with the background turning to black and the text turning to white and moving apart. Now just a quick note with match and move, there are certain things you can change about elements and it still recognizes it as the same element to animate. For example, with text, you can change the color, you can change the transparency and even the size. But if you change the actual copy or the font, it recognizes it as a different element, and so it won't do that smooth animation between them. And for some items, this is just a matter of playing around and experimenting to see what works and what Canva will let you do. So once these pieces of text moved apart, I wanted the word now to come in, and that came in from the bottom, just using this flow transition effect between these two slides. Now, if I click on that transition, all flow does is it moves all the elements in a certain direction at a little bit of a haphazard kind of speed, so they're all going at a slightly different speed. So you'll see if I hover over it, the hello and let's begin move at different times, and the now comes up from the bottom because I've chosen this bottom arrow here. Once the word now was on screen, I then wanted to change it to a different size to have it kind of punch in so that it gives a really kind of powerful beat effect, which I wanted to time to the music later on. Then for the next slide, what I wanted to do was actually really overwhelm people with bright color behind this word. And so I found an image from Canva's image library and I put it behind, and I made the text smaller and white so that it stands out. So that was again just using the match and move animation or transition. It allowed me to just create that effect really smoothly. Next, I flipped the image so that there was a bit of movement, even though people wouldn't necessarily notice it. And I brought in this big line of text. And if I click on that, you'll see it's actually off the page here, and it animates on using a custom animation. And the way I did that was, I have this line of text, it's slightly off the screen, and I click on it, and then what I did was I went to animate, I went to create an animation, and then I'm actually going to just click and drag that text box until it's in the position I want it to end in, and then let go. Then what I chose was the smooth option from the movement style, made sure that the speed was as low as it could go, and then click done. And so what that does is it just animates it along that path that I drew, which in this case was straight from right to left. So if I move along at the bottom in the timeline here, you can see how this text now slowly animates in and runs off the screen to the left, just as I dragged it. Next, I went again to a white background, and I had four text boxes with different words in. These are four separate text boxes, and these are animated just using the scrapbook animation from Canva, which brings them on in this really fun, almost cartoony way. Now, you'll see I've also added a Canva element, and this is just an animated Canva element, which I found in the library, and I have placed underneath this text so that it seems to actually focus on the word create. And this was just for this slide, and you'll see if I drag the playhead, as that text comes in, when create lands, that zooms in, and then it carries on for the rest of the text. Now to get that text off, I used the match and move again, and in fact if I go to the next slide, if I select all, you'll see that those words are actually still here, but they're off the edge of the page. The other thing you'll see is that I have a block of text here which you can't see, and that's because I wanted to move on the next slide. So again, using match and move, if you click and drag, you'll see that text actually moves on to where I want it to be in this slide. And that text I wanted to be in a bright pink. Before we go any further with the video, if you enjoy learning about these kind of animation techniques and how to use Canva to its full potential, and also how to plan and organize your projects within Canva so that it's not overwhelming and it's easy for you to create, then you should probably be on the waiting list for my upcoming Canva course. I'm really excited that enrollment's going to be opening just in a couple of weeks, so if you are interested in learning more about Canva from me, then sign up to that wait list and you will be the first to know, because we're going to have an early bird discount for people who are on the list. And you never know, there might be a new bonus in there somewhere. It's a really great course. The feedback has been amazing. So please sign up for the waiting list, and I will let you know as soon as enrollment opens in a couple of weeks. The next slide, I really wanted something that added a bit of movement in, so it wasn't just the text moving, and I also wanted something to carry on this theme of art or creativity. So I found a video in Canva's library that is just essentially a line of paint being painted. So if I move the playhead along, you'll see that on the next slide, that text seems to fade out, but actually all I did was use match and move to change it to white. And then the video in the background plays with this paint being spattered behind it, which seems to reveal that text again because it's in white. Then I used match and move to change the text to black and move it to the right hand side of the screen. The video disappears and another line of text appears on the left hand side of those words to be free. That text is just animated in using a standard typewriter text from within Canva, and again I used the pink dot to ensure some consistency with the colors that we're using. Next, I moved that text back to the left again, and as you can see, the small block of text on the left-hand side I rotated and moved off the screen, just to give that effect of dynamic or kinetic text. So here again, you'll see I have actually changed the word to be white, so it seems to fade away. And then we just have the words be free. And then I brought in, with a pop effect, that little pink dot. Now the next slides, which are the last ones in this whole process, I wanted to be really quick, and I wanted it to give this effect of something being splattered or dropped onto the page. And so I've got a very sharp transition with a splat, which goes over the dot, and then another one with an even bigger splat again, which goes over most of the page, And then those are just very sharp transitions, which are going to be very short, hopefully timed to the music. And then for the last one, I just used a simple stack effect for the final slide, where the words end just come in from above and kind of land and finish off the video. Then I have added a final slide in where my logo comes in, but that's actually after the music ends anyway, so it's essentially just a tiny bit of branding to add in. Now there you can see that pretty much all of those animations and transitions are using just standard Canva animations, and I've just used them in a way that helps that text look more dynamic. One of the key things is to think about on each slide where the text is coming from and where it's going to. So at the beginning of the slide, is the text already on the slide or do you need it to move on? And then at the end, is it going to stay there? Is it going to change? Or if it's not, how do you want it to move off? Do you just want it to disappear? Or use that match and move to move in a specific direction, etc. So it really is just about taking your time and working through your process, making sure that each slide is considered almost as an animation section of its own. And then you can piece them together and speed them up. Now, before I added the music in to actually get the timing right for this final version, what I wanted to do was add in a couple of sound effects. Now, you may not know, but in Canva, there's actually a sound effect library. If you go to the audio app, if you don't have access to it, just go to apps and you'll see it's one of the ones at the top here for audio. And then you can actually search for sound effects. So for example, I wanted to use a spray paint can for that sound effect of the paint. So if I type that in, you'll see it actually comes up with a whole range of them, which you can then just play and preview and then choose the one you want. And all you do is just click it and drag it into the timeline where you want it. Now, if I click on this yellow one here, which is this spray paint can sound, you'll see it pulls up the audio channels underneath the video so that you can see what's here. And this is where you can see where that sound is. You can click it and drag it and you can trim it and just listen to it as you go along. And you can just run the playhead along so that you can see the sound effect starts roughly as that spray paint comes in and then disappears to the next slides, which just have the music behind them. I also used a bit of a whoosh sound, which just adds a bit of depth to animations, which I used behind this element that I included on the video. So it just creates this kind of whoosh effect as that goes over the text or under the text. Then the next thing I did was to find a piece of music that I liked, and I put this in, and then I literally just went through and using these guidelines of where the peaks and troughs of the music is, I tried to time my slides so that they fitted with that. Now, within Canva, if you click on the sound, you can actually go to the beat sync at the top here and allow it to sync it automatically for you. Now, that works really well, but it will change the timings of things. And because I wanted very specific timings on some of these slides, I decided to do it manually. But as I say, you can actually look at that waveform of the sound and you can then time things to where those peaks are. Just as a quick side note, sometimes it takes a while to find the right music and the right sound. The bottom line is that despite all these super video producers on YouTube that show you how easy it is, sometimes it just takes a while to find the right music, particularly if you're trying to find music that is royalty-free and that you can use. Canva's music library has some great options in it, but you do still have to go through and listen to tracks to see which one works for you. I do have a favorite music library that I use. It is paid, but it's very affordable, and I pay for that every month so I can use music for any of my videos without worrying about copyright infringement or anything like that on YouTube. Now, the library I use is called Upbeat. They're not sponsoring this or anything like that. It's just one that I actually have found has such great quality music and sound effects that it's the one I go to first now, and it really is worth paying the, I think it's like $10 a month. But I'll leave a link in the description below the video. As I say, it's not sponsored or anything. I just really think they have great quality music and sound effects. So if you are looking for additions to the Canva library, that's a great library for you to go and have a look at, or rather have a listen to. So once those are all in and I've tried the timings, I am just going to play through again so you can see how it all comes together and where those sound effects come in. And that's it, folks. A dynamic or kinetic text animation just using text boxes and a couple of elements within Canva and using only Canva's animation and transition techniques. I really hope you found this useful. If you did, please hit the subscribe button and hit the like button so that I know that you enjoy these kinds of tutorials. Have a fabulous week and I will see you next week.